As fairgrounds are becoming more scarce, these carousel horses are being used more as decorative items, and when they're not on their carousel and they're just stood up, sadly, they tend to break the legs.
To make sure the legs are reattached securely to the body, Alex drills the upper leg to insert strong dowels and slow drying glue.
I don't need an expanding glue in this joint, so I don't want it to push the joint apart. Although it'd be nice and convenient to have it set quickly, I'd rather be patient, let it set nice and strong.
Once the upper legs are solidly in place, the lower leg can be carefully reset.
I'm using masking tape because it's a very flexible way of clamping the joint. Essentially, it is like bandaging up the horse. I mean, because this joint is all bent and it's all 3D and all various angles, I can only use tape here and just wrap it round, hold it in place. Very much like a bone setting, really.
Once this carousel horse is structurally sound, Drew wants the stripped away paintwork restored. In the paint restoration studio, armed with the results of Rebecca's research, Jill's preparing to restore the carousel horse to its original hind colours, a white dappled with grey. Jill mixes each shade by eye, using enamel colours and an oil-based white paint.
It's important to just add the paint a little by little, otherwise you can end up wasting quite a lot of paint. I tend to stick to the earth colours because they would have been used originally. Paint was made, historically, from whatever you had nearby. And earth colours are just that. They're the colours of earth. You get red, yellow. Real yellow ochre, I think it comes from the Forest of Dean. What we're looking for is the grey of a horse's coat, only an old grey. A little bit more black and a little bit more brown.
Finally, the colours can start to go on, beginning with lighter shades and then building on darker patches to create the naturalistic dappled grey of the classic hind carousel horse.
I know from having owned horses that they are all they're different in colours all over. They, you know, they're shaded, they're subtle, they're a live thing. And the aim with this is to make it look as near as possible like a real horse. Putting the paint on and then and taking it back off is one of the most important things. It's old. It gives it multiple tones and then texture, if you like. Texture's the modern way of saying it. It sort of enhances the look of the mane and gives it a little bit of wear, which is, of course, what you need. The red in this instance is for his nostrils. Most fairground horses had flaring red nostrils. Very dramatic. That's the colour it would have been when it was new, 100 years ago or more. Paintwork's been done, and it's very much as it looks like it would have done when it left the factory or the painter shop. But that's not the look we're going to be going for. We're going to be going for an aged and distressed look, as if it's been loved and patted and all those sorts of things. It just needs to not look quite so fresh and new. I'll take a Stanley blade in this case, make some small chips right through to the wood, so that when the glaze goes on, you will see wood. You've put all this work into this horse and to make it look as perfect as you can. Sometimes you think, oh, I'm not going to take that bit out because that really worked well. So you lay off that bit a bit. But generally, I don't mind it so much because generally when I've finished, I'm happier with it looking old than I am with it looking new. I'm working the glaze into the areas that I know would remain dark because they wouldn't get anywhere. Wear is always on the exposed, sharp and proud pieces, so because the glaze collects in the depressions and gathers there where there wouldn't naturally be anywhere. Over the years, I've seen a lot of old paintwork. It's a tricky one to balance. You've got to keep the decorative appeal and yet make it so that it could fool you. If it can fool me, it's done its job. Enjoying doing this bit, it's the fun bit. It's everything you've worked towards to recreate that old and battered carousel horse look. And this being the final stage, you can tell whether you've got it right or not.
The way that she's aged the saddle, aged the mane, it's just absolutely brilliant, and really, it's brought the horse to life.
3 weeks ago, this horse was badly damaged, with paint that had been brutally stripped away in a caustic soda tank. Now its broken legs are healed and its colour work marvellously restored, looking as though it's been ridden and loved by thousands of children during its century-long lifetime.
Well, blimey, that looks a bit different, doesn't it?
Amazing, isn't it?
Wow!
What a beastie.
That's incredible.
It's a gorgeous thing. The paintwork is amazing.
Isn't the paintwork good? She's a genius, isn't she? Mm-hmm.
It just looks original, doesn't it? It looks nice and aged.
I know what Jill can do, I know what Alex can do, I know what they can do together, and Jill's work is second to none. It's as good as it gets. You won't find anybody who can put antique paint back on something and you can't tell.
So it's had all the legs repaired, so it's nice and solid.
I'm glad you left that.
Yeah.
You know, like, I love old repairs like that too.
It's a cracking bit of character, isn't it?
She's very clever. Where she's put the wear is where somebody swing the leg over there,
yeah,
and where there'd be kids' hands around the front here, like nail marks.
Yeah.
She's actually put nail marks from, you know, kids hanging onto it on the front.
And I just love, like, the relief and the depth on that mane is quality, you know.
Very clever.
Worth only £500 when Drew picked it up, this horse could now sell for at least 10 times that, and perhaps a lot more.
We found out it's by a German chap called Hain. There's one of these for sale in America. It's $27,000.
Someone that knows how to ask.
Yeah, yeah.
You've got stuff to learn after all.
I've got things to learn.